morning dear student, welcome to the class. I'm teaching you chapter number 9, work and energy. In previous class, I have explained you about the types of energy. Types of energy. These are heat energy, electrical energy, then yes, solar energy, fourth one is wind energy, fifth one is mechanical energy, then sixth one is sound energy, good. Sound energy. And last one is light energy. Now, what I'm going to teach you today? I'm going to teach you today about renewable and non-renewable source of energy. Renewable and non-renewable source of energy. Okay, we start. Various sources or resources are characterized as a renewable and non-renewable source of energy. And a renewable resource, this one can replenish itself at the rate it is used, while a non-renewable source of energy has a limited supply. Renewable resources include timber, wind and solar. Renewable resource includes what? Wind, solar means sunlight and what? Water. Non-renewable resources includes coal and natural gas. Non-renewable sources include coal and natural gas. Resources is energy, or renewable energy is energy that is collected from the renewable resources, which are naturally replenished on a human's time scale, such as sunlight, wind, rain, tides, waves, and global geothermal heat or global heat. It can be replenished. These resources are not cause any pollution to the environment because they are natural, so they are not causing any pollution in the atmosphere. They are inexhaustible. Inexhaustible means never runs off, unlimited, in a huge amount. They are inexhaustible and are not affected by human activity. Means when we are doing any activity, it is not affected. Water is not affected, air is not affected. I mean, they are there. Yes, they are polluted sometimes, but these energy, solar energy, wind energy and water energy is always used by the humans and they are not affected by any of the activities. Non-renewable energy comes from sources that will eventually run out or will never be replenished in our lifetimes. Most non-renewable energy sources are fossil fuels. What are fossil fuels? Coal, petroleum and natural gases are fossil fuels. How? And carbon. Yes, carbon is the main element in fossil fuels. As you all know that we all are made up of carbons, animals, plants, these all are made up of carbons. So, fossil fuels are formed in 200 to 400 million years ago when the earth was a lot different with the landscapes. When the dinosaurs are there, then there is a lot of change on the earth landscape. So, that makes the fossil fuels. How the fossil fuels are formed? Do you know? Fossil fuels are formed. And what are fossil fuels? When at the time of dinosaurs, when the earth is changing, the earth land is changing, that time plants and algae grew in these ancient wetlands. They absorb sunlight and created energy through photosynthesis. They get energy and they are living because they are preparing food and they are growing. After the time is changed, when they died, the organisms drifted to the bottom of the sea or lake. These were energy stored in the plants and animals when they were died. As you all know that we all are having a energy in our self. Plants are also having energy, so they are storing the energy, and when they are died, what happened over times, the dead plants were crushed under the seabeds, rocks and other sediments built on the top of them. They covered all the plants and algae or animals which are dead at that time, and they are covered with and they are sediment under the sea beds, so creating heat and pressure on them, that the sediment parts, the heat and the sediment parts give the heat and pressure on that plants and algae which are already dead. Plants and animals remain eventually turn into fossil fuels. Coal, natural gas and petroleum are the best example of fossil fuels. The main advantages of non-renewable energies is that they are abundant and affordable. For example, oil and diesel, petrol, we can buy and use it. And its disadvantages are, first, fossil fuels took millions of years to form, and second, they release carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, which pollutes the atmosphere. Thank you, student. Your homework is to learn the lesson.